It really is the age-old question. It's up there with what killed the dinosaurs. When it comes to peanut butter, which is better, crunchy or smooth?
It's got to be crunchy.
Oh, well, the Pommie Boys, Will and Steve, they're travelling around the country to find the answer, and they join us now. Hello, boys. First of all, are you two divided?
We are. For the first time, I'm smooth and he's crunchy.
Hey, look how smooth he looks.
He's very smooth.
Look how crunchy he is.
You said that you're a bit rough around the edges.
I am rough around the edges. And quite flubbery somewhere
as
well.
Oh, rubbish.
Because we've been eating too much of dessert.
And are Australians quite split when it comes to smooth versus
crunchy?
We
weren't sure how split they would be, but, you know, we were in Martin Place on Wednesday, giving out 2,000 samples, and everyone wanted to be involved. Everyone was excited, wanted to say their piece, and I was actually surprised, but crunchy won.
Crunchy did win.
Yeah.
It's because I'm more charismatic,
down.
I think.
Now, you are whipping up a delicious treat for us to taste.
Yes,
has
very,
it
very quickly.
And smooth?
Well, no, this one's going to be... So we've got two different pots that we've created two recipes for. Using the peanut butter. This one we're showcasing is the crunchy pot that we've got. So we've got a little banoffee pot. So we've got some...
A banoffee?
Yes. That's right.
So is that English?
Well, I don't know whether or not it's English or not. Aussies seem to love a bit of a banoffee pie, don't they?
Banoffee pie.
Yeah. So maybe
it sounds like a state of mind. I'm a bit banoffee.
So you've just added how much peanut butter, crunchy peanut butter?
We've got a couple of tablespoons of peanut butter. We've got two bananas. And then we've got 250 grams of mascarpone. Pony, yogurt and cream.
Which peanut butter are we using?
We're using crunchy today.
The good nut peanut butter.
Good nut made by Biggie.
So what we've got here, we're going to make a little instant cheesecake. So we've got some thickened cream, we've got some mascarpone cheese, which is just going to make that nice thick setting.
It smells delicious already.
I know, and that's it. And then we've just got some unsweetened yogurt that's going in there as well.
Right.
So it's going to be nice. Again, it's a quick instant cheesecake. It'll set in the fridge nicely and hold. You don't need to add any like setting agents or anything like that. So it's nice and simple.
Wow.
You could put it on a base. You could break some biscuits up with some melted butter and set that as a base. And then that's just going to go in and I'm going to mix that around, try and make as much mess as I can because then it's going to make plate.
But what I'm actually going to do is we're going to layer the dessert. So to make it a banoffee, it needs to have some toffee in it. So we've got a dulce leche, which has been infused with some more peanut butter. So it just gets more.
What did
more
you say that was?
Dulce leche.
What's that? I've never
That's
heard.
When you feel really
it's
sad.
Like an it's like an Italian caramel.
Right.
But we loosened it with a little bit of cream and we just added some peanut butter to it as well.
Oh, it smells so good.
It smells amazing. If you were allergic to peanuts, because lots of kids have allergies with the whole dessert, couldn't replace it.
You can definitely just take the peanut butter out.
Okay.
But that's why we're here, I guess.
Yes, that's true.
So we just pop some peanuts into the jars. So you can serve this any way you want, in jars, in bowls. You can have it all separate and everyone can dip in and
choose.
That's the trendy thing.
Maybe on a chopping board, a basket.
So this is the trendy thing to do, Denise, chucking it in an old jam jar.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And Will's...
It's all about the layers.
I remember when we had to put it in a jar. Because we didn't have any glasses.
Jesus, how old are you?
Oh. Jeez, make friends, Will. Make friends.
I didn't have any glass then. No, I'm just joking.
Will won't be coming back.
I'm old enough to be your mother.
lucky there.
I am.
Hey, Denise. Lucky
you look young enough to be my sister.
There we go.
Recovery. Please invite me back. How are you getting on over there, mate?
Good, mate. So we've got a layer of peanuts. We've got a layer of dulce leche. We've got the banoffee mixture going on top.
Yes.
And then I'm going to be finishing it with a little bit of sweetened cream in the cream gun. And this is the moment where...
Now, when you say sweetened cream, is it literally just some sugar with some
whipped
cream?
A little bit of icing sugar.
A little bit of icing sugar,
into the cream, just to take the edge off. Like, I mean, this is pretty sweet as it is.
Whatever you put in there, you could have on your own.
Why don't you lick that?
Exactly.
No, thanks.
Are you sure?
So this could go anywhere, so I'll do a little test. Oh, we're good.
It works. It works.
Oh.
So what do you do if you don't have one of those at home, mate?
Just whip it. And then pop some peanuts on top.
A little sprinkly sprinkle on there.
How fab does that look if you're having people over and you wanted a fancy schmancy dessert?
It's delicious.
It's really straightforward.
Spoons in. There you go, Sarah.
We're going to have a little taste.
You can have the one with all the dulce leche still on it.
So where will you be next handing out delicious food?
We're going to be in Federation Square on Wednesday morning.
Yeah.
So we'll be pushing out 2,000 samples, two different desserts. We've got a tiramisu version as well, which will have the smooth peanut butter in.
Yeah.
And it's the great debate. It's smooth versus crunchy. We want Australia to vote.
And we've got a load of samples for everybody in the audience. Here's some people prepared earlier. And for you guys over there as well. Don't you worry, Jess.
Why not? You're peanut intolerant.
Because I have to have a bum operation. So I can't eat.
Oh, I'm having a colonoscopy.
Oh, yeah. Ah. Ow.
That just put me off my...
Do you need a hand with that? Do you need a hand with that? So we'll bring these out to you in a minute, guys.
You two are so gorgeous. You are welcome
thank
anytime.
You,
I'm sure the audience will agree.
Oh, thank
you. Will and Steve, everyone.
Thank you, guys.